talking about you.
And as always, we'll see you.
Is Zoho marketing automation confusing the hell out of you? Well, you're not alone. There's a ton of people out there who feel the same way. So make sure you tune into these tutorials to make sure that you get your system set up properly at the start. In today's tutorial, we're going to show you how you can go about using the editor to make sure your campaigns are perfect. So let's log in and I'll see you there.
All right, so now that we're logged in, let's go ahead and start creating our content using the Marketing Automation Editor. Before we start though, let's go ahead and add a few images to our library so we can access them anytime we need. So we're gonna click upload over here from our computer. So let's add in that one and then let's add in one more. We should be good now. So now I have both of these images I want to use, and we're going to use in the editor. So now that they're uploaded, we can go to our engagement section. We can go to our email campaign, and we're going to be creating a goodbye email campaign. So this is where someone comes into our service and they're no longer going to be continuing on with using our services. So we want to thank them for, you know, being a customer with us, spending their money, and just appreciating them on their way out. We went through and just created a very simple email again. So we're now going to go ahead and start adding content. So we're going to choose a basic template, and this allows us a couple different options here. So let's just choose, you know, this option here and say we want to use this. So it's pretty basic. It does allow us to be able to edit it. So let's say hello. We want to use a merge tag over here and let's say contact's first name. So this allows us to use these variables within any of the custom fields or anywhere throughout. And that just allows us to use that. So we're gonna say we are incredibly sad to see you go and wish you all the best. And then I'm also going to insert an image over here. And so I'm gonna drag and drop this into that section there. So over here, I'm going to add one of these. So I'm gonna use this image. It's gonna say time to say goodbye. So this is gonna be the header. And then we're gonna have hello, individual name. Then we're gonna say we're incredibly sad to see you go and wish you all the best. As always, please feel free to reach out if you ever have any questions. And then in this one, we are going to insert our other image. And then we have that. And we could end it there if we wanted to. We could delete this component here. So now it's gone. We want to get rid of this as well. We don't need that on a goodbye email. We may want another button. So we could throw in a button here. Actually, we have these options here. Let's choose the more rounded one. And we can say re-enable account. So something like that. We want to say URL. And we're just going to put it to google.com right now because we don't really have anything we want to do with it. So this is just an option to re-enable account. Let's say we want to add in more text. We want a regular text size. So we're going to choose this one. We're going to put it there. If you deleted your account in error, please click the button below to re-enable. Now, for the most part, one thing I would say, and this is something I say to all my customers, is that if you do have the ability to utilize some of these templates, it's a lot easier than reinventing the wheel. It just saves you that little bit of time. You can certainly start from scratch. It just may not be worth it in the end if you're having to do, you know, a newsletter every time. It's better to create a template and kind of build it out from there. And this is fairly basic stuff. When it comes to Zoho Marketing Automation, you'll get more familiar with it as you come along. So it is all the same. So these are all the basic fields right here we can add. We can also add advanced. So we can add in widgets, dynamic content, attachments. We can create a poll, a video, calendar invite. We have the various layouts down here. And then if we want to change the design, we can change it in here within our template as well. Yeah, so we can insert HTML and you can insert HTML code. So that is something we can also do. And then we can add in different tables. So we can set up a table here. We can also set up a grid pattern and we can set up a basic over here. And then let's delete this. So this is pretty much it for being able to change the content of an email. We can change the size to 8 pixels for the header and the footer in this. We can also add hyperlinks and remove hyperlinks, add anchors, we can add bullets. There is basically anything you'd expect in a text editor we can do, we can add that in. And in this case, I may actually just add a little spacer here. I'm gonna add that in there, and I'm gonna add 30 there. So this is really just playing around with it. And one of the things we can do is, let's just save the changes now. Let's preview and test. And this is the nice thing because we do have the ability to go through this preview and test. So we're gonna send it to our email address. Let's send it and see what it looks like. There it is. So we now have hello fname, because in the testing side of things, it doesn't actually pull in that information. So it will only ever be fname. Unfortunately, it doesn't pull that in during testing, but when you send it out, it will be like that as long as it's set up properly. So we have this over here. Let's just view this email. You've clicked the view browser button. To view the web version of your testing, please send email campaign to a sample mailing list. We don't really want that. And for some reason, the text didn't show up over here. So we know that there's now a problem because of that. All right, for some reason, it didn't like these spacers in here. So I deleted them, re-added them, and then I saved the changes again, and now it seems to be working good. So if we go back over here, we can see what this would look like. And we can see that everything looks mostly good. There's obviously some formatting issues. For example, this button over here, we can go through and edit that. So let's click on this button. It looks a little bit different in here. Let's change the button properties of the design. So we want height style, let's go curve, and we want width to be, let's just say 150, and we want the height to be 50, because we want that to look a little bit better. So I think that looks pretty good right there. So let's save. It looks better than what it did before during the preview and test. So let's see if it actually looks like that. So that looks a lot smoother in my opinion. So I think I'm pretty happy with this. So I'm going to continue on with it. And I'm actually going to save to library. So I can now save this as a template. So I'm gonna add in this as a goodbye template. And I'll now always have this and can use it anytime I need to. So there's other products we could even specify if we so chose, now that we've saved this as a template. So we really don't have to worry about it. Let's get rid of this logo. We don't really wanna show our logo. So this is the first thing they'll see. I think this looks pretty smooth. So we're gonna call that there for now. And we've saved it to the library. We're gonna save the changes here. Let's just save it as, just because I removed that logo up there, I want to save this as goodbye V2, and I'm just going to create it. So now that we're done, we can click next. And now that we're here, we can actually go through like we did with any other campaign, like with the other campaign we've already created. We'll just select the contact list we want, make sure that the two are selected that we do want to go out to, and then we'll just click next. And again, this issue has not been solved yet, so I've been contacting support. And what's gonna happen is you're gonna send, there's gonna be a button here that's send for review. And then after that's done, they'll email you saying your email's ready to go out. And you have to come back to this email and say send. And at that point, your email campaign is out to all of the users that you've sent it out to. So we hope that's been helpful, showing you a brief overview of what you can do with the editor. We'll dive into a bit more advanced stuff in a future video. And make sure you subscribe below. We wanna make sure this content is getting out to everyone who needs it. So please make sure that you share, you comment, you subscribe. We want everyone who's struggling with this kind of stuff to know about it. And make sure that you subscribe to our Facebook channel, our Instagram channel, everything like that. We have a ton of good stuff that comes out, and we want you to be a part of our community. And we'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.